Hi and welcome to the third of our videos on homeostasis. Today we're going to be looking at blood sugar regulation. Glucose is a very important compound as it's needed by body cells for respiration, and we get our glucose through our food. Once we've digested our food, our blood sugar level increases. What then happens because of that, the pancreas produces a hormone called insulin. Insulin then enters the bloodstream, and what that does, it allows the body cells to take up glucose, which is needed, as I mentioned, for respiration. Any excess glucose is then converted into glycogen by the liver. Therefore, blood glucose gets reduced. If blood sugar is too low, say you've had a period of fasting, then the pancreas stops producing insulin. What this does, it just means that less glucose is absorbed by the cells, and therefore blood glucose increases. What also happens is the pancreas also produces another hormone called glucagon. What this does, it tells the liver to convert glycogen back into glucose. Now it does this because glycogen is just a polymer chain, so it's very similar to starch. And what happens is you've got your individual monomer units, which are glucose molecules, and these are broken off one at a time and released back into the bloodstream. Okay, so here we've got our negative feedback loop, and you can see just what controls or regulates blood sugar. So you can see that if we have an increase in blood sugar levels, the pancreas makes insulin, the blood transports the insulin around the body, where it's picked up by the body cells and also the liver, where it's converted into glycogen, therefore reducing blood sugar. If it's too low, the pancreas stops making insulin and starts to make glucagon instead. Glucagon is transported around the body, and the liver is where glycogen is converted back into glucose and put back into the bloodstream, which overall raises blood sugar levels. If this feedback system doesn't work properly, it can lead to conditions such as diabetes and also hyperglycemia, which is high blood sugar, and hypoglycemia, which is low blood sugar. Okay, so that concludes this short presentation. Hope you enjoyed it, and don't forget to keep a lookout for some more videos coming up soon.